I thank the organizers of TAN CSI 2019 for giving me this opportunity. So in the next few minutes, I'll be presenting OCT guided left main PCI. The 80-year-old man, evolved atrial MI with moderate LV systolic dysfunction with history of 20 years diabetes, referred for revascularization. The angiogram showed osteoproximal left main 30-40% stenosis and distal left main 70% with proximal LAD 70 and mid has a thrombus containing 95% stenosis and LCX was showing 80% stenosis. So he was given the option of CABG quite naturally. In 80 years they refuse once taken up for PCI to LCX and LM to LAD. So the LAD and LCX were wired with BMWIs and first 2x15 balloon LCX lesion was prepared and 2.5x18mm expedition stent was deployed. And this is that showing the, this is what the software is showing, fade in, fade out, in which we can see the stent apposition and vessel wall. And then LAD lesion was prepared with, before doing OCT, since lesion was tighter, I prepared with 2.5x18 balloon at 14 atmosphere in LAD and 20 atmospheres in the left main. And currently the, for stent optimization, OCT recommendation has been upgraded from class 2B to class 2A. And the newer trials like ROC2 trials also support the feasibility of the OCT guidance for distal left main stenting by detecting the suboptimal PCI of like under expansion, molar position and dissection better than angio and IVUS. And also the OCT is recommended intravascular imaging if the device during the procedure does not proceed in a predictable way or for complex lesions like calcific lesions and all. And it's safe and feasible. And this is the pre-PCI pullback. And this shows that iotosteal has a fibrofatty plaque with the distal left main showing more of lipid-rich plaque and mid-LAD and with calcium in proximal LAD and left main. And if you carefully see that here, this 31.6 millimeter, as Dr. Shivakumar was pointing, the length of the lesion from osteal left main to the landing zone was also detected, and the diameter of the vessels and how much of post-dilatation balloon has to be taken, 3.25 EL in proximal LAD and 4 EL in proximal left main. So with these measurements, you see that the iotosteum shows a fibrofatty plaque while distal left main has a calcium less than 180 angle, and you see more lipid rich plaques in LAD and bifurcation spots, proximal LAD also calcific. If you see the area, it was 2.7 millimeter square in case of distal left main, which is a very critical lesion. And you see that I put a hanging wire technique so that the guide could not deform the stent. And so with that hanging wire, so I can trace with the osteal left main, which is not possible usually with OCT. So here I was using that.
Check. Clear?
Sorry. So if you see the what is seen inside was the hanging wire. So with that, I could see that that's osteal left main. And so I can able to take the length, which came as 31.6 millimeter. So it was, as we know, the EL is 3.25 for LAD and 4 for the left main. So 3x12 NC balloon is taken with 14 and 20 atmospheres respectively in LAD and left main. And a 2.75x33mm Zines expedition was placed from osteal left main 2mm pulled into the aorta and deployed at nominal atmosphere. Since we know the EL, I had taken 3.5 NC balloon and dilated with 14 and 16 millimeters in LAD and 18 millimeter in left main. And after that, post deployment and post balloon dilatation, the OCT run was taken. And if you carefully see that, the as automated lumen border and also in the L mode, the stent was very clearly, the opposition was clear. There's no mall opposition. But if you see, according to the double reference technique, this is used doing Aptiview technique. The expansion is 65% in LAD and 78% in left main, which is below. So I have taken again a 4 balloon and went into 24 atmospheres and brought the area to 9.22 millimeter square. So because we had done the EL by pre-PCI, I was able to take the higher balloon and to vent to the higher pressure. So what is the minimal stent expansion index, which is the most important post-PCI MSC, detects the restenosis and stent thrombus. That is for LCX 5 millimeter square, for LAD 6.3 and bifurcation 7.2, and for LMC it is 8.2. So by this, so OCT very important in predicting the good optimization, reducing the stent expansion, mall opposition, and finding out the edge dissections. We can safely do a OCT guided left main stenting. Thank you.